Hi, I'm back again. This is First Record Response, and this is Asylum Choir. Leon Russell and Mark Benno. I have no idea what this is going to sound like, never heard it before, and I'm not going to lie, I actually do not know what to expect. I've seen this in a lot of thrift stores. It's one of those thrift store records that just get thrown away all the time. So I'm expecting it's probably going to be pretty horrible, but who knows? I've actually heard the first stuff these guys have done in the 60s, late 60s. It was like a Sgt. Pepper's type of influenced album in the late 60s, trying to do all that production stuff. As you can see here, I mean, they're very pretentious in that album, so I'm assuming there's going to be some pretentious stuff in this album. I mean, look at that picture. It seems like they're down for some serious, serious recording, serious business right there. Look at that. All right, here you go. I'm just about ready to play this thing. Like I said, I heard the early work, not that bad. It's still corny. But I'm ready to put this one on, see what Asylum Choir have come up with on their second album. Okay, right away, I actually do not know how to really critique this. I mean, it kind of sounds generic already. It sounds corny, but it's not terrible. I mean, that chorus isn't bad, actually. I don't know. By the way, along with this record, I'm drinking a Baltica porter. I believe it's like a Russian beer. Pretty good. So far, not terrible, I must say. I mean, once again, I don't know what to think. I mean, I don't know. Gosh. I guarantee if I heard this on digital, it wouldn't be. I think it would be more clear cut if it's bad or not. But, you know, vinyl, everything sounds better, so it's hard to tell whether this. Can't tell. I mean, is this bad? Is this good? I could tell. Yeah, it is. It's not great. It's his voice. I mean, he's trying to have like some kind of accent or something. Like some. I don't know what kind of accent that'll be. Is that his real accent? Who knows? Looks like they're going for like the soul type of feel for this album. They left that psychedelic vibe they're going for in the 60s. Well, actually, this is 69. And I already feel like it sounds like a 70s album, like a 70s ballad driven album. Like, this could easily be a 1970, 71, 72 album. It's more about the songwriting, it's more about the singer-songwriter, about the concept. It's already got that feel. Even their singing especially is very 70s. Like, ballady 70s, ready for commercials. Play, airplay. Once again, not a great song at all. Very mediocre. I don't know. It's once again the same sound that was so repetitive on the first side. It's come back. They haven't had enough of it. They want the sound more. They want more of the sound. I guess people will dig it. Obviously not. I mean, some people probably dig it. Obviously, these records are everywhere. But they're not a very celebrated band, I don't think. I mean, I only heard of them through their 99 cent or $2.99 bins. Not their records being in those bins, the $2.99, 99 cent bins. Their records, this record in particular, is always in there. And it's beginning to show why. I mean, it's not awful, it's not terrible. And that's the weird thing about, even if albums are discredited and presumed to be trash, doesn't mean they're trash. They're just not that exciting, or it was a miss. You either hit or miss, and these guys missed with the sound they're going for. Not a bad sound. Well, it's almost bad, I would say, but it's not terrible, I would say. Definitely better than the last record I reviewed. Like, that guitar tone's cool. That guitar tone is really, really awesome. They should do more with that. Forget the piano, ditch it. Electric piano I dig. That sounds cool.